If you have wrinkles or if you have crepey or crinkly eyelids, sometimes when you apply eye makeup, it emphasizes it even more and makes your wrinkles more prominent. In today's tutorial, I'm going to be showing you how to do makeup on wrinkled eyelids and keep the emphasis away from those wrinkles and fine lines and keep your eyelids looking smoother. So if you're ready, let's begin. I don't have very many wrinkles, but you can clearly see the crinkly skin on my lids. We can get wrinkles on the eyelids as we age because of loss of collagen. Or if you see a lot of crinkly skin, it could be just that you're dehydrated because you don't drink enough fluids. So it's very important to take care of inner and outer health with hydration and nutrients. When you have fine lines and wrinkles, two things to keep in mind are 1. Keep everything matte, and 2. Keep everything minimal. I'm going to start with my brows and I'm going to keep it minimal. I'm going to be using the Precisely My Brow pencil by Benefit Cosmetics and fill in just the sparse areas. By keeping it minimal, you're making it look soft. And when you make it look soft, everything around it also starts to look soft. Now, if you make it harsh, everything including the wrinkles will also start looking harsh. Ever wondered why your makeup moves and settles in those fine lines and never stays put? It's probably because you're not starting with a clean lid and there's oil deposited on your eyelids. So it's always important to start with a clean eyelid by using a mild cleanser. I like to use the micellar cleansing water because it does not irritate my eyes. I'm just taking a little bit with a Q-tip and I'm going to gently erase all the dust, dirt, gunk and oils that are settled on my lid. As far as skincare goes, I always recommend starting with a good eye cream, and my favorite is the Tatcha Silk Peony. This is an anti-aging eye cream that melts to release a double shield of hydration, so it'll get into all those fine lines and it'll smooth out everything around your eyes. I personally love this cream because it gets absorbed into your skin in no time and it doesn't leave your lid looking greasy. Next, I like to use a tinted primer. You can use just a regular eyeshadow primer which has no tint, but I like to use tint because I have discoloration on my lids, and the one that I'm using today is the P. Louise base in the shade Rumor 2. One reason why you can see wrinkles and fine lines is because they have depth to them. They're deeper than our regular skin. So by using a primer, especially a tinted primer, because you're evening out the skin, the wrinkles automatically become less visible. Let's look at the before one more time. And here's how it's looking after we've primed it. So you can see how less visible those wrinkles and fine lines are. And before this eyeshadow base starts to crease, I'm going to lightly set it with a translucent powder. I'm going to be using the Hailey's Retouch Powder. This powder is so finely sifted and it is so soft. So I'm going to be applying a very light layer just to prevent this eyeshadow base from creasing. If you don't set it with powder, it's going to settle in those fine lines and emphasize it even more. For eyeshadows, try to stick with something that's simple and matte. I'm going to be using the 35F palette. This is from Morphe. I'm going to be using a matte brown eyeshadow on my lids. Using a flat fluffy brush, I'm simply going to sweep it on my entire lid space. Try to avoid shimmer eyeshadows because they highlight everything, including your fine lines and wrinkles. Shimmer eyeshadows, metallics, as well as glitters are heavier than matte eyeshadows, so they don't settle on your skin like the matte eyeshadows do. And they highlight every little detail on your lid and skin, and sometimes that can also look heavy and cakey. Instead, when you use matte eyeshadows, it looks a lot smoother and lighter on your lid. But you can most definitely play with matte colors to give more dimension. I'm going to be using a deeper shade of brown in the outer corner to give my lid some depth. Next, focus on eyeliner. If you have crepey, hooded or small lids or lots of wrinkles on your lids, I would suggest focusing on the eyeliner rather than the eyeshadow that'll emphasize all these details even more. It doesn't have to be a complicated, elaborate, extra long wing kind of an eyeliner. You can keep it small, classy, and close to your lash line. Because the main focus on today's tutorial is to keep it minimal. Another thing you can focus on is lashes. So I'm going to curl my lashes and apply a coat of mascara. The one that I'm using is the highly rated mascara by Milani. Lashes automatically make your eyes look more youthful. So by focusing on lashes, you take away attention from the wrinkles. At the same time, because the focus is on keeping it minimal, we are not going to be using any false lashes today. Sometimes false lashes can be heavy. It can weigh your eyes down and that can make your eyes look more droopy. In your lower lashes, you can completely avoid applying mascara, or if you prefer to apply mascara, keep it to your roots and not to your tips, because applying too much mascara can make it look like you have dark circles. Another way to make your eyes look bright and youthful is by using a nude eye pencil in the outer half of your lower waterline. I'm using the Rimmel Nude Scandalized Pencil, and I'm going to list everything in the description box right below this video for your reference. That's it, my friends. I hope you found this information helpful. Please thumbs up if you did. And if you're new here, please consider subscribing to watch more videos from me. I love you guys so much, and I will see you soon with a brand new one. Bye, guys.